In this video, let's see another topic based on matrices and determinants, and the topic is named as adjoint of a matrix. Now, adjoint of a matrix is what? It is related to the study of cofactors and transpose, which we have already studied. So, it is advisable before watching this video, at least go through the previous videos of cofactors and transpose. Now, always remember that adjoint of a matrix is always calculated only for square matrices. We do calculate adjoint only for square matrices, and that is why we'll be studying it only for square matrices. Now, since you see that we have 2-3 lines written about adjoint, we'll be reading it after we understand how to calculate it with the help of some numerical example. So, basically, adjoint of a matrix is what? You know how to calculate cofactors? You do what? You just calculate the cofactors and then take the transpose, and then you get the adjoint of that matrix. What I mean to say is, let's see with the help of a theoretical approach and analysis. Say I have a matrix A, and that is a square matrix of order 2. If this is the case, the elements are what? They are A11, A12, A21, A22. This is the matrix, which is a 2 by 2 matrix, and it is of the order 2 by 2 or order 2, it's named as A. Now you know the cofactors would be what? The cofactor matrix would be denoted by C, and that matrix will have the cofactors. Cofactors you know are what? Suppose I want to calculate the cofactor for A11, I'll be leaving the row and the column, I get A22. Right? And that A22 will be taken into consideration the sign also. Minus 1 raised to the power I plus j is the formula we did for what? We did for cofactors. I need minus 1 to the power I plus j. Now that means we'll be having some values. Let me denote the values randomly by C11, C12, C21, C22. The values may be anything. They may be minus A22 or something of that sort. Even that is a 2 by 2 matrix. The order does not change. Now, the adjoint is calculated how? The adjoint of the given matrix A is basically what? It is the transpose of this matrix, which is the cofactor matrix. That means adjoint of A is the transpose of C. And what is the transpose of C? Transpose means interchange the rows with the columns and the columns with the rows. So, if you have C11, C21 as the first column, this will now become your first row. And the second column will become the second row. So, it is C12, C22. This is what is the study about adjoint. That means any given matrix which is a square matrix, the adjoint is what? It is nothing but the transpose of the cofactor matrix. Now, let me read out the definition. Then we will be taking some numerical example. So, if A is equal to Aij be a matrix of the order n. Order n means what? It is a n by n ordered square matrix. Right? The Cij be the cofactor of Aij, Cij, that means C11, C12, these are the cofactors. Then the transpose is what? Then transpose of a matrix of cofactors. Transpose of cofactors. Transpose here that we calculated of cofactor. This you see, transpose of a cofactor is known as the adjoint, is known as the adjoint, and it is denoted by Adj, that is adjoint. So, it is denoted by Adj of that matrix, of A matrix or B matrix, right? Now, let me take again an example and then things will become more clear. I have a matrix, say again the name of the matrix is A, the elements are something called as A, B, C, D. And I'm supposed to find what? I'm supposed to find the adjoint of A in the question. Now, if this is the case, my solution will go something like that. My task is to go about this step. I know that adjoint A is equal to transpose of the cofactors. So, first let's calculate the cofactors. Right. So, what is the cofactor matrix? The cofactor matrix is nothing but the cofactors should be listed. What is the cofactor of A? A is the first element. To find the cofactor, leave the first row, leave the first column. Right. You get what? You get D. So, you write here D. And I also know minus 1 to the power I plus j has to be applied. This is the first element, that means A11, that means A11, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 is even. So minus 1 to the power 2 gives me plus 1, so it is plus sign only. Now let's go about finding the cofactor for B. B is what? It is A12. 1 plus 2 is 3. Minus 1 to the power 3 means minus sign. So firstly put a minus sign. Then for this matrix element, that is B, I need to ignore some things. I need to ignore this row. I need to ignore the second column because B is here. So what is left? Ignoring first row, ignoring second column, I am only left with C. So I write here C. Similarly, quickly let's go about finding the cofactor for C. Finding the cofactor for C means you need to leave this row, you need to leave that column, you are left only with B. Why leaving second row and first column? Because C is placed here. So leaving everything, you get only B. So you write here B. You also need to take into consideration the sign. Minus 1 to the power I plus j, it is here. That means A21, 2 plus 1 is 3. Put it here. Minus 1 to the power 3 is minus sign only. Minus 1, place minus. Last but not the least, if you have D, D is what? It is the last element, cornermost element. For this, you need to ignore again certain things. Since D is placed here, remove this row, remove that column, you get A. And what about the sign? The sign is what? 2 plus 2, 4, minus 1 to the power 4 is plus 1. So it is plus only. This is cofactor. This is not the answer. The answer is what? Adjoint is transpose of the cofactor. So take the transpose. So you get adjoint of A is equal to transpose of the cofactors, and taking the transpose of this matrix, you get what? Rows becomes columns, columns becomes row. So it is D minus B minus C A. Now this is the answer for adjoint. Now there is also a short trick. Either you calculate it fully and write the answer, but the short trick you must apply only for a 2 by 2 matrix, which is this case. So for a 2 by 2 matrix, the short trick is what? Directly you can find out the adjoint. You have the elements A, B, C, D. The answer would be what? The answer would be interchange the diagonal elements. A and D are interchanged. You've seen the answer? A and D are interchanged. The first step is this. The second is what? This diagonal element need not be interchanged. Only the sign needs to be interchanged. What I mean to say is, if you're going about this matrix, in this matrix to find the adjoint, first of all you interchange this. So for this matrix, directly the adjoint would be what? The adjoint would be a simple answer, and that simple answer would be interchange these elements. As you saw here, you need to interchange these elements. And the next thing that you need to do is A12, A21 will not be interchanged. Only their sign will be changed. This is plus sign, make it minus. This is plus sign, make it minus. That is how you go about it. This is simply the answer of adjoint A for this matrix. And again, I'm explaining that in case of 2 by 2 only, this trick will apply. Interchange A and D, interchange A and D, interchange A11, A22, A11 into A22. Last but not the least, if this is B and C, make it minus B and C. If this is A12, A21, make it minus A12, minus A21. Again, one more example for the adjoint. Quickly, let's understand what is the adjoint of the C matrix. C matrix is given to me as 1, 2, 3, 4. The adjoint is what? Let's write the answer. The adjoint of C by this trick will be simply what? Interchange 1 and 4. So 4 and 1 this side. Last but not the least, 2 and 3 is given. So make it minus 2, minus 3. Even if you calculate by whole thing, you take the cofactors and then you place the signs and everything, then also the answer will be this only, which is obtained by the short trick. But the short trick applies only in case of a 2 by 2 matrix. That means 2 rows, 2 columns, 2 rows, 2 columns. For 3 rows, 3 columns, that means third order matrix, everything has to be calculated. First calculate the cofactors, then take the transpose. That is how you will be getting the adjoint, which we will be seeing in the next video.